Ah! running to court. Afghanistan के लिए आ जाएगा श्रीमान. Thank you.
Friends, let me at the very onset extend my heartiest congratulations and compliments to everyone present here, my colleagues, my very dear students, families, guests, ladies and gentlemen. Every year we meet here, people take it as a ritual, but in my opinion it is more than a ritual. It is a day we all need to celebrate, and we all need to be very proud of that we have a republic which is, if you compare with any other country, I would call it as the most functional republic. I do not know how many of our young students would have gone into the details, but our constitution was the one which took a lot of time, and after doing a lot of reading, our forefathers came out with the constitution that we have, a very vibrant one. It has undergone many modifications, many changes, but it has stood the test of time. It is because of this that we are standing like a rock, we are standing as a one nation, despite the largest diversities that you can think of. You look at any other country, there'll be one race, one language probably, one kind of similar habits. But our country, I had indicated earlier also in one of my Republic Day addresses, you travel 50 kilometers, the dialect changes. Travel 100 kilometers, the food habits would change. The dress code would change. But what remains common in all of us is that we have stood like a rock. Nobody has deterred us from our path that we have been following on. And our country is the only one where from the day one we attained independence, everybody got a voting right, irrespective of qualifications, your gender, your area, your caste, creed. Everybody had an equal right. And that has given us the real strength. Democratic strength comes from within, and everybody in the world has seen the maturity of our democracy, the way we do everything in our country, the way we conduct elections, the way we pass on the baton to the next one. What a smooth transition it has always been. And this is a lesson which I think the countries, even some of the very mature democracies in the world, are learning from us. You have seen the recent happenings in one of the very important countries in the world, the way they had gone around and how depressed they felt after that. But fortunately, we have given the highest respect to our constitution, always. Last year I had given you lots of examples on how well we have done in the recent past. We have seen, of course, but then some of our young friends would always be wondering about what kind of a country is it. We don't have the right living standard, and we don't have that kind of resources which others have developed. But they don't realize the kind of problems that we faced after independence, no other nation would have faced. Our priority at that time was on three sectors: health, infrastructure development, and education. Nothing else. We never bothered about roads, developing hill stations, developing five-star hotels. All those have come over the years, and we are now celebrating 72nd Republic Day. Now, if you compare where we were in 1950, when the Constitution came into force, and where we are now, I'm throwing a challenge at everybody. Where we were and where we are, it'll be a moment of proud for everybody. Last time I gave you the examples of the kind of food productions, the way we have come up, milk production, largest in the world. Well, all those things are a matter of great pride. There is no doubt about it. I will now, in the next 2 minutes, focus on how well we have faced this pandemic. People were bothered. People were disturbed initially. I remember the date, 22nd March, when our vibrant Prime Minister Modi announced the lockdown. People were wondering why this kind of a step. But now we have realized that had we not taken that, probably we wouldn't have reached where we are. We have reached almost a situation of herd immunity. We are facing this much better. If you compare the death rate, the cases, the recovery rate, everything is something one can be really proud of, that well, how well we have done, it is for everybody to judge. I'll give you a few highlights of this. On 22nd March, we were having no PPE kits. We were having no thoughts about vaccination. We were having no ventilators, not enough ventilators. We were not having enough resources. And everybody thought that if this is the way we are going to be doing, we have no testing kits. We were not comparable to anywhere with countries like Korea, Japan, US, Germany, England. The way they were testing, we were having nothing. And we were really disturbed how we are going to face this pandemic. But look at the way, hats off to our scientists, hats off to our healthline workers, our police force, our frontline workers, in fact, our IT professionals, the way they came up and faced this, I think it's something we all need to be very proud of. And I think every country in the world is looking up to us, that here is a country who can face any challenge in the best possible ways without getting disturbed about any of the worst situations. A few things. We were not making any PPE kits at that time. And within 2 weeks, the way we developed, the number has been very large. Now we are producing about 10 lakh kits every month. We were not having enough ventilators. The way we managed, it is a lesson for everybody. Then people all over the world were saying, well, India cannot produce vaccines. The way we came up, it's something to be proud of again, something to be very happy about. A lady by name Dr. Gagandeep Kang in ICMR gave a right direction. All others joined in, and now we are on the verge of developing three vaccines. Two we have already done it, third is on its way. This is something remarkable which our scientists have done. This is one. And the other part, the testing kits we were not having. We literally begged. Our diplomatic force did a remarkable job. They talked to US. US said, we are facing our own problems, so we cannot give anything. England, Germany, everybody refused. Finally, it was Korea, who said, okay, we will give you a shipload of testing kits. And a ship started from Korea. It is towards the first week of April. Instead of reaching Bombay, it unfortunately strayed into and reached somewhere near an African country. And had it started back on its own course, it would have taken 3 more days. And we were in need of this. There is a young scientist in our country by name Dr. Naveen Khanna. He had produced a kit for dengue fever, and it was a kit which was 10 times cheaper, better performing, faster, and it will tell you what way the dengue fever would progress. So he said, here is a kit which if we carry out little modification can be effectively used. And since we didn't get any kits from Korea on time, we started using his kits. And the way our country is now testing, it's something which everybody has seen. And 78% of the kits are being used, which are being used, are from Dr. Naveen Khanna's discovery. This is something we should be very, very happy about, that here is a force which can rise up to any level. When we look at the international scenario, the way we have faced our hostile neighbors, it's for everybody to see. And everyone has appreciated the peaceful endeavor which India moves on. And we never look at any other country that we'll be occupying their land, we'll be forcefully entering into somebody's territory. We have always respected international boundaries. We have always respected international laws, and we have always given due respect to our neighbors, despite their hostile attitudes on occasions against us. So these are some of the few things which, if you all think about, and if you all look at, I don't know, I mean, our youngsters should be very, very proud to be belonging to a country which is on the move. Which is on the move despite all difficulties. Other countries will not have these kind of problems. Our economy, of course, during pandemic has gone down, but it is looking up again. In the education sector, there was a time we were all huddled up in our own houses and we were so disturbed. We were all wondering whether we'll ever be able to get back to our normal situation or not. But again, I would have highest appreciation for our IT professionals that every part of our country, remotest part of our country, is now connected. And we started having regular meetings, we started having regular classes. We started, the whole nation moved online in the shortest possible time. And people all over the world said, well, India, well, they have developed vaccine. India cannot develop its own app so that they can, they'll always be using Google Meet and other Zoom and other apps. We said, no, we can come up. And they came up, JioMeet. They came up where you can connect more than 100,000 participants, 150,000 participants. They tested. So we have shown the world that there is nothing that we cannot achieve. And that has come in not a very long time. America took all these to give voting rights. They took more than 100 years. To get to where we are, they took more than 150 years. But where we are, within a span of 70 years. This is something, if you compare with other countries, even United Kingdom did not give voting rights straight away to everybody. They gradually gave it to matriculates, then to graduates, then to females. But did we do any of these things? Nothing. 1947, we got independent, and then everybody was equal. Highest sense of equality, we gave it there. And the way we have moved from one step to another, I think I would urge all my young friends to be very proud of and to work towards a strong nation building. We can do it. We have done it earlier. We are capable of doing it. Only thing is, we need to be working in a very focused manner. And if we all do our duties, we talk about our rights, but I am particularly urging our young friends that if we all do our duties properly with absolute sense of sincerity, I think there is nothing that we cannot achieve. For us, people all over say that, well, this, if you do this, we are going to have everything within our own scope. Sky will be the limit. Sky will not be the limit. I will always say, work with absolute sincerity and everything will come your way. It'll fall on your footsteps. And sky will really not be the limit. We will be even going beyond. And therefore, I give you my highest level of compliments on this 72nd Republic Day. I urge all of you to to pay utmost respect to our constitution, move in a manner that we show the world that here is a country which can lead the way, which can lead the world to be a good, livable, peaceful place where everybody would be a happier lot, not the one where people are suffering from all kinds of problems. We will show them what we are capable of. So I congratulate all of you and hope we all march together towards peace and prosperity. Thank you very much. Please join me in saying Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.
Thank you.